and Michael Strahan.
It's Friday, February 4th, 2016. Welcome to the show, everybody. Yes. Interestingly enough, the audience now is behind me. Hi. Hi. I mean, like, way behind me. Like, I got to turn around to see them. That's new.
Yeah. We got a lot of people in here.
Yeah, are we adding people? Can't we, like,
rearrange?
Move them over that
just
way?
Just rearranging.
Having a hard time. I don't know.
Well, I feel sorry for these. I mean, I don't think they got to.
Yeah, these are the VIP seats.
How y'all doing behind the camera over
to
there?
To me, the VIP seats are always so funny because you really can't see anything.
So how are you doing?
I'm great. How are you?
I'm doing great. How was your night?
How was yours?
Mine was, nothing, actually. Yeah, I didn't really do much. I went to Lure Fish Bar and had a meeting, so I just went down to Lure. And
when we lived down there, we used to live at Lure constantly. It was my kid's favorite restaurant.
Yeah, I love it.
Yeah, it's great.
And so I was just down there, had dinner, and I was home, and I was in bed early.
Good for you.
Remember yesterday when I said I go to bed by 9:30, and everybody was like, oh! Well, last night I was in bed by 9:30. Yeah. Feeling good today. I got some sleep.
Me too. Well, I didn't actually get some sleep. I watched the debate, the political debate, the Republican debate, with my children. So yeah, okay, so you know then what happened. So won't do that again.
I watched it, and then after a while, I just had to turn it off. I couldn't watch it anymore.
No, I watch it. I've been trying to, like, I want my kids to understand the political process. They're really at great. My older son obviously knows the political process, but the younger two are asking about delegates, superdelegates. How is this, you know, the difference between Democrats and Republicans and the platforms? And so we've been trying to watch everything, the town halls, which I love because nobody's shouting over anybody and everybody is, like, getting their message out. And then the debates. And last night's debate was, I have to say, and this is a nonpartisan comment, this is coming from a mother, was so undignified, I don't know where to begin. And I don't know if I can't watch this with my kids. I don't even know what to say about it. Like, if my kids spoke that way to each other, they would be grounded. They would really be grounded.
Yeah, I didn't want to hear any arguing after. At first it started out and then everybody's fine and then it's more of an attack. So when that starts happening, I'm like, why even waste my time?
No, it started
out.
There's
nothing that you haven't heard before. So that's what, like, the thing is. It's like, I'm not hearing you argue about something I never heard you argue about before. You know, it's kind of like me and my brothers back in the day. It's like, enough, enough, go sit down.
No, this was like I feel like this was a whole new level. And
so,
for those of you who know what I'm talking about, I just, like, I don't even know what to say. I don't know what to say. I don't know what to say. It has nothing to do with politics. I know that much. So I just am, you know, at a certain point, you have to say, we as taxpayers deserve people who are willing to talk about the issues and only the issues. And I'm tired of personal insults. Tired of it. It's like just trying to hear them talk about something other than the insult. I don't know. I got very upset. It really upset me last night.
Well,
I think because I was like, because I watched with my kids, and I was like, this is something we can do as a family. And then I was like, no, we're not. Joaquin, go to bed. Close your eyes. Cover your ears.
Yeah. Well, I'm over it.
Anyway, that was my message for the day. As I, again, it's coming not from a political place. It's coming from just a decency place.
Well, if I had this option, this is what I would have done last night, because I still haven't seen Star Wars.
I cannot believe that. Are you crazy?
You know what? I'm just the guy that when you say, you gotta see it, I'm like, it makes me want to wait. I don't know what it is.
Yeah, but to
just that rebellious part of me is kind of like, oh, I'll get to it when I get to it.
Yeah, but
just because you said
to see it in 3D is really cool.
I have a 5D TV.
I'm sure
stuff
you
is shooting out the
I'm
side.
Sure you do. I
like
don't know
say
what
you
that
got
means.
People behind
but...
me. That's how my TV operates. Stuff is all around. But you know, but it would be great to see it in the theater. But you know, I very rarely make it to a theater. But what they're saying, it's going to be available on April 5th on demand and on Blu-ray and DVD.
I'm gonna watch it again.
So I get a chance to watch it.
We've seen it 3 times.
You've seen it 3 times?
Movie
wow.
theater. Yes.
But you know what?
We grew up. I mean, that was like.
No, when I grew up, it was big. But I just haven't made it to the theater to check it out. But they're gonna have behind-the-scenes featurettes and 7 deleted scenes that they didn't put in the movie. And the movie has earned $2.05 billion to date. And then you know how much they're going to make off the DVD sale. I mean, it's going to be amazing. And I will be one to buy it.
Yeah.
So I haven't seen it yet, so I can catch them on Star Wars.
I keep thinking, like, the company's making so much money. Maybe we can get craft service here soon. No? Oh, okay. Nope. Nope. Still no craft service. Sorry, guys. Sorry, no coffee for you.
I think that's more Gelman than actually than the company.
I keep hoping, though. Anyway, you should see it. It's really, really.
I've only heard great things, and it kind of slipped my mind, and the next thing you know, it's already passed.
Well, especially if your kids aren't in town. Like, if your kids aren't in town, you're not going to, like, I wouldn't just go see Star Wars, like, on a Saturday night. My kids say, come on, let's go see Star Wars again.
Uh-huh.
And I go, okay.
Oh, okay.
You know, okay, we'll do it.
Can somebody let me borrow their kids this weekend?
Yeah. Yeah. Who do you want? Which ones
Somebody's too willing to give their kids up. They're like, take them here. They're yours. No, I bring them back, okay?
Hey, they're saying that, you know, there's snow today on the ground. You see that?
Yeah.
Yeah? And they're saying this is winter's last gasp.
Oh, I hope so.
They're saying that this is it. This snow is going to happen, and then it's going to be springtime galore around here. 68 on Wednesday?
On Wednesday, next week.
68 on Wednesday. There are people in the audience from Florida like, oh my gosh, it's gonna be so cold. It's gonna be so cold here on Wednesday. You know, right. How do you like winter? Yeah.
Well, that's why
you're kidding. You know my in-laws, right?
That's why you love the snow because you live in Florida.
They live in paradise.
You come up here and you dally in it, and then you go home.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Is that your only sweater? That's your only sweater, right? My mother-in-law has like 3 sweaters. She keeps them at my house because she doesn't really need them ever. But they're saying it's going to be the last gasp of winter. They're saying 70 degrees, Gelman. 70 degrees on Wednesday. Holy cow. Anyway, they always say this, though. They lull us into the falsest sense of security. And then it's May 1st. And then there's an unexpected snow squall that comes out of the north.
Because that's a crazy thing. They tell you this is the last gasp.
Right.
But they only give you a 7-day forecast.
Right.
So how do you know it's going to happen on the 8th day?
Because they're reading that Farmer's Almanac. Those farmers are telling us again.
I wish it were that easy.
So listen to this. It really is having a negative effect on certain things. You know, the Iditarod, that dog sled race.
So
in Alaska, it's so warm right now that they've had to ship... there's pictures up there. They're shipping train loads of snow for the opening ceremony because they don't have enough snow, which is really troubling because, you know, you think Alaska,
right.
You think snow.
Right.
That's like a guaranteed, right? Well, it's not guaranteed.
So for the Iditarod, they have to ship snow.
They have to ship the snow.
Those dogs are up there running going, man, it's hot out here this year.
You know, Mark did that when we did the... We did the show in Canada. and Mark did that dog sled race. And he said what's fascinating about it is that the dogs go to the bathroom while they're running. He was not, you know, expecting that. So you're piloting the dog sled and look out behind you. Because...
Oh, yeah, you can't stop.
Yeah,
they don't stop. And if you try to stop, your buddies are pulling you.
But think about this. As a human being... if you didn't have to stop to go, think about how efficient we would all be. Right?
I'll be honest with you. Sometimes that's the only peaceful time you get. Not speaking from experience, I'm just saying. And do you remember Brandi Chastain?
Sure.
Of course.
Yes, you know, great friend of mine. I love this woman. She's so amazing. And she kicked the winning penalty kick in the 1999 Women's World Cup soccer match. Here she is right here. And then she did this. Show those muscles.
Yeah.
And, you know, that was like such a big moment for U.S. Women's soccer. Mm-hmm. Well, she now, and she's 47 years old. And she announced that she's going to pledge her brain to the Concussion Legacy Foundation yesterday. Huh. And what they're going to do, they're going to study her brain to see if she has CTE, which is from the movie Concussion with Will Smith, and what they found a lot of ex-athletes, not just football players, but athletes, have had from collisions. So I think that that is an incredible and very noble and great thing that you're doing, Brandi. So I just wanted to shout you out on that, my friend.
Great lady.
Great lady.
So the Obamas have decided, according to this New York Times article, that they're going to stay in Washington after they leave office.
Wow.
Because their youngest daughter is still in middle school and they think it's an important time. They want to let her finish out her school with her friends. And I think it's great. It's something
they're going to stay until she graduates. High school or just middle school?
I think middle school. She's in the middle of high school. She's a freshman right now, I think. Because I think she's Lola's age, right? Maybe? Mm. Yes? I don't know. They're saying that transferring someone in the middle of high school is very tough. And it is very tough. And so they're going to stay there until school's done. So good for them. I think it's a great thing to not have, like, upheaval,
you know what I'm
during
thinking
those
of?
Years.
You know what's so cool? Like, you're riding around D.C. with your friends, and you're like, yeah, that's where we used to live. My bedroom right there, yeah.
I like the way you impersonate her riding around.
That's how I would be riding around if I were DC. Yeah, that's my old house. This is how I ride. And another thing, we talked about it the other day. We talked about, you know, surgery and people, you know, doing things to themselves.
Plastic surgery.
And plastic surgery. And I say, you know what? When you get tired of seeing yourself on TV, or you think you look a certain way, you don't like the way you look, before you do anything to yourself, it's time to just fade away. I mean, that was for me personally.
I agree, which is why I gotta go.
No, you're not going anywhere.
Bye, sweetie.
You're not going anywhere.
I'll miss you.
I refuse.
Bye.
I refuse to take your resignation.
All right, now I gotta go. I gotta go, guys. Bye.
You look incredible. You look incredible.
No, you said when you're.
Well, I said me.
Don't.
You look incredible. You look great.
You said when one is tired.
No. We're all tired. But you talk about aging gracefully in Hollywood. Yeah. Now, George Clooney said that he thinks pretty soon he is going to retire as an actor. No. I'm just reading it. I didn't say it. And he's going to retire because I think nobody really wants to see anybody really aging. And he's going to go behind the camera because he's a great director as well. And he said, you know, your choice in roles changes and become less and less as you age.
And that's George Clooney saying it.
And that's George Clooney. He said you just try to look your best and the best you can and not worry about it. But, I mean, if this guy is saying he's going to retire, holy smoke. If he's going to do it. Yeah, if he's gonna do it, I'm leaving after this show today. I'm done.
Me too.
Oh boy, and we all have things. Does Mark throw away a lot of stuff around the house, old stuff, or does he cut?
Mark is the most efficient person when it comes to clearing things out. He clears things out. I have to make sure I'm home because he will clear out things that have sentimental value. We had a storage unit once, and he was cleaning out the storage unit, and I caught in midair my wedding dress. It was going into the dumpster. Like, nothing has sentimental value. It all just goes. If it's not making a streamlined appearance, it goes.
Wow. He needs to slow it down because there's this anonymous family.
Yeah.
Who were cleaning out the great-grandfather's house in California earlier this week.
Mm-hmm.
They found this, like, crumpled up brown paper bag. They opened it up.
Mm-hmm.
There were 7 authentic Ty Cobb baseball cards in it.
Wow.
That were printed between 1909 and 1911. And they were only believed to be about 15 of these cards in existence before they found this bag.
Unbelievable.
And now these 7 cards command or worth over $1 million.
Wow.
That's incredible.
Yeah. So I will be in my base, my attic, if anybody needs me.
Probably was like
this afternoon. Yeah. That's right. Crazy.
All right, well, should we move on?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Already?
Hey, Tina Fey.
All right, I just
Bianca.
wanted to show one Downton Abbey clip. But
okay, sure.
Yeah. Yeah, it's, you know, Downton Abbey's it's bidding us adieu. It's going, yeah, I know, it's sad. And we were all saying that we're really sad around here, not so much that we'll miss the show, but we will miss dressing up like the people from the show for Halloween. So we just want to show you, we want to leave you with one last Live's Halloween Downton Abbey clip. So take a look.
We've lost everything. We're ruined.
Ruined?
Ruined.
Ruined.
Ruined?
Let's do something to save Downton.
What to do?
What to do?
What am I gonna do?
I'm gonna miss using my accent.
Yeah. I just want Art to dress up like that all the time. Why can't we have Art in a wig and lipstick and false eyelashes every day? Please?
He's not we'll having it. There he is. You're not having it, Art.
Please, where is Art? Where did he go?
He's hiding.
He's hiding in a corner over there. But we have a big show today, everybody!
Hey, guess who's here? Tina Fey is here. Tina Fey.
Yes, Tina Fey. And also, Priyanka Chopra is here.
And today is Live's first edition of Live's Flashback Friday, where we will be sharing some of our own flashback photos. So will Tina and Priyanka, and we want you to send us yours.
Yes. So either right into our inbox with your photos, or you can go and send it to us on Twitter or Instagram and use the hashtag LiveFBF. And we will we'll look forward to seeing them later on in the show, and we get a chance to show some of them, okay? Oh, I hate when I drop my snowballs. All right, everybody. Our dancer is in position, ready to go. And let's kick it off with our Snow Wild Travel Preview.
Is Veronica Lisbon from Ambler, Pennsylvania.
Hey, that was some hot stuff over there.
Hi, Veronica.
Now, Veronica, great job, by the way. Thank you. And let's say hello to Kathy Perkle from Vancouver, Washington. Hello, Kathy, how are you?
Hi there, Kelly and Michael.
Hello. Now, Kathy, what do you do for a living out there in Vancouver, Washington?
I'm a labor and delivery nurse.
What?
Oh, my gosh. You are, let me tell you something about you, Kathy. You are the most important person in the world.
You're nice.
Are you working right now?
No, I'm not. I don't work today.
You know what? You have a very subtle, like, soothing voice,
yeah,
too. If I were
oh,
having,
thank you,
if I were having a baby, I'd want you there.
Hey, Kathy, I heard from my my OBGYN that when babies come out that aren't so cute, you guys say, "Oh my gosh, what a baby!"
I guess that has happened.
Well, you know, well, we're gonna, you sound like you're a very stressful business, so we're going to hopefully be able to send you on a vacation somewhere, spin the wheel.
What a day. prize, the Tradewind Island Resorts in St. Pete Beach, Florida. You can go visit my in-laws or the lady in the last row. It's 7 days and six nights. It includes one spa treatment per person. This trip is provided in part by Hotels.com. It's a prize valued at $4,300. You have 20 seconds and only one guess, Kathy. Good luck.
Thank you.
All right, here you go, Kathy. On yesterday's show, we talked with John Stamos. In addition to his legs, what other part of his body did John say he was self-conscious about? What other part
his
of
his belly button?
You got it.
Congratulations. You and a guest will enjoy 7 days and six nights at the Tradewinds Island Resorts, located on St. Pete Beach on Florida's West Coast. Just voted the number one beach destination in the USA by TripAdvisor. Enjoy endless beach activities, dining in beach bars, an exciting kids program, spacious accommodations, and more. You pack your things, we'll pack your stay. Tradewinds Island Resorts. Your prize is valued at approximately $4,300.
Congratulations, Kathy.
Thank you so much.
We were just flashing back to John's belly button.
Yeah.
Now listen, you get to help make the day of a lucky member of our studio audience who will receive a $500 appliance package from Cuisinart. So please pick a number between 1 and 235.
30.
Yeah. There we are. Kathy, congratulations. Thank you, young lady. Congratulations to you too, everybody. Stay right there. When we come back, the very funny, the very talented, the very beautiful Tina Fey is here.
Still ahead online, we'll show you some of Kelly and Michael's flashback Friday photos. Don't forget to send us yours. From Quantico, Priyanka Chopra and...
Is that like, have you been in training for something?
Sure, yes. For that.
Yeah.
And now, we just saw you at the Oscars.
Yes.
Where you made everybody's list the next day of best dressed, by
yes.
the way.
Yes, you. I heard you. I made
you
your art. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
And as you know, the live Oscar fashion panel is the most respected one of them all.
In all of journalism.
Yes, all of journalism.
But thank you.
Do you like doing the red carpet, or is it weird?
It's
for
kind
you?
Of fun. I mean, that dress was Versace, right?
It's
that was
beautiful.
Like, you know, I was so grateful that they would make that for me. And you spend all day getting ready, and you're like, okay, I got this. And then you get there, and you, like, I rolled up, like, in front of Charlize Theron, and I was like, oh, hey. I forgot. I'm an idiot.
do you like the process of picking out the dress? Do your kids help you?
Sometimes they'll come over, they'll bring a bunch of dresses over, and it's, I don't know if you have this, it's very stressful because I have a four-year-old, and the four-year-old just be like running to the dresses, and I'm just saying, like, please have clean hands. Please don't have peanut butter on your hands. And my dog will be there like trying to like eat the bottom of like the hem of a jeweled dress. So it's stressful to do it at home.
We do it here at the studio, and basically everything is like, Tina Fey didn't want any of this.
No.
And that's like what we try to. But it's good. We're grateful. We have. It's good. We like it.
But you talked about, you saw Charlize Theron. I think you saw her on the red carpet when you were standing with me.
I was standing with you.
Because I'm standing with you and I hear you go, wow.
I cursed. I turned to my guy and said, oh my God, we're not on the air, are you? Because I saw her and I was like, oh.
Yeah.
Right.
Well, I cleaned it up by going, whoa.
And then I started I started spontaneously clapping. I started, I was like, who am I clapping for?
Was there any like celebrities that you're starstruck by, or like a highlight celebrity?
I mean, that night is pretty bananas, right? Because you see
everybody.
Everybody. I went to the Vanity Fair party. I saw Caitlyn Jenner came in, and I was like trying so hard to be like, I was trying to make friends, like, have an interaction with her, but she was through the room. She was a big deal. I saw Selena Gomez. You know, it's a crazy party when you're like, oh, I'll talk to Selena Gomez. Like,
right.
There's like somebody I know. Like, I don't know Selena Gomez.
There's a picture. My daughter loves Nick Jonas.
Yeah.
And he was talking to somebody, and there was a photographer there. So I leaned into the picture. And so I was like, look, I got my picture taken with Nick Jonas. She's like, he's talking to somebody else. You're just leaning in. But it's like, makes you feel that
way. Like a big deal, yeah.
And now your girls are 10 and 4.
Yeah.
And have they started on social media? Because that's always been a contention with us here, with our kids.
Yeah, we're right on the cusp with the 10-year-old. She has an iPad now, and I set up the thing. She can, like, if she's home with the Wi-Fi, she can, like, text her cousins and, like, one or two friends. And
right.
I set it up so that everything she does also goes through my phone. Mm. So I'll be like, oh, somebody's trying to get hold of me, and I'll look, and it's just, like, 50 poop emojis that she's
next.
Glad I got up for that. And I also realized that, I was like, oh, this is not great. I realized that because it's all linked, my internet search history goes into her iPad's internet search history.
Oh, no.
I'm not up into anything shady, but, like, still, like, stuff that you might look at online, like, you don't want them to see. I saw a thing that was like, Hitler had weird genitalia. So I, like, clicked on it, and I was like, oh, that's in her.
Right, I clicked on that. You know? We also clicked on that. We, like, went right to it. I was like,
now it looks like she looked at that.
I know.
We should talk to that.
You gotta erase your history. Constantly erase your history. Now, we have, it's Flashback Friday around here. We're doing this thing now. We're getting on the bandwagon of Flashback Friday 10 years after it happened.
Yeah.
So, we have a picture of you, right? A flashback picture?
I hear that you do, yeah.
Yeah, let's see.
Oh,
Is that your senior portrait?
That's my senior portrait.
Yes. Everybody wore the same black thing, right?
Yeah, like, they just threw it over your thing, and they gave us all the same fake rose to hold.
Yeah. It's like The Bachelor.
My haircut is pretty respectable for a 1988 high school graduate.
That's majorly good.
Like, because it could have been like this. It could have
like
been
straight up. It could have been like mine.
Yeah. Do you have yours?
Mine is hideous. Mine's embarrassing.
Yeah. It was totally opposite. Your hair was short and down, and yours was big.
I'll show you during commercial break.
Yeah.
It's embarrassing.
You went very New Jersey, Texas on us. We're going to take a quick break. We come back. We're going to talk to Tina about going to war. So we'll be right back with Tina Fey, everybody.
Still ahead on Live from Quantico.
Trot, yeah. Gotta say it correctly.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. Now, this is based on a book written by a real, a war journalist.
Yes, this woman, a woman named Kim Barker, wrote a book about being a journalist in Afghanistan. She went over there thinking she was going to stay for 3 months. She stayed for 3 years. She kind of got addicted to the lifestyle of chasing these dangerous stories by day, and then apparently the reporters party very hard when they're not working. So it's just like...
Is that true?
Yeah, apparently.
That's what keeps them there.
That's what keeps them there.
Wow. Yeah.
But this movie has a lot of action there. You're shooting guns.
Yep.
You're flying in helicopters.
Yes.
Now, were you ever scared? Because that sounds scary to me.
I got to fly in a Huey helicopter with Air Force pilots, and they kept saying, like, are you going to be able to do that? Are you going to be scared to do that? And I just kept saying, like, I don't know. I won't know until you walk me up to the helicopter.
Right.
And I go, like, no! But it was actually awesome. I loved it. Because once you get in, and a female pilot named, I believe her name was Mary Clark, and she was, like, 28. She was so cute. She was 28. She had braces. She's like, sorry, I got braces. The Air Force is paying for my braces. She had already served two tours. But once you get in there and you're with these Air Force pilots, you're like, oh, they got this. Like, this
right.
is, like, would I take, like, an Uber copter to the Hamptons? No.
Right.
But this, I was like, give it the Air Force pilots are, like, unbelievable.
And they're all so young and smart and, like, brave. And brave.
So
the bravery of people is amazing.
Yeah. When you compare it to my own cowardice, it's so impressive.
But the gunfire, was it hard to learn to fire a gun, to shoot a gun?
Yeah, I took it real seriously. I fire an AK-47 in the movie, which is a serious weapon. And they go through this. It was a real one with blanks in it.
Okay.
They take you through all this weapons training, and they spent the whole morning, like, training me. And then when I finally went to go, like, shoot it, and they were like, and rolling, and everybody, and then, like, way in the distance, I just saw, like, coming over the hill in the desert, just the snack lady carrying, like, a little tray of mini hot dogs. And I was like, no! Not now! Huge weapon.
Incredible. Never shoot that gun.
No, they're the most important
people on the set. Hey, listen, it opens today. The name of the movie is Whiskey Tango Foxtrot.
When we come back, Priyanka Chopra will be here with us.
You are a a breath of spring. They tell us springtime is coming
I'm channeling spring because I go back to Montreal right now as soon as I finish your show to shoot Quantico. So I was like, you know, I'm going to be in like minus 200 degrees or something.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, I'm from the tropics. I don't understand that. Yeah.
But don't you love Montreal, though? Isn't it like the greatest people, the loveliest?
Lovely people, lovely food, terrible weather.
Right. Well, you're there at the worst time, I think.
Yeah, I've been there
like
this is the
6 months
time.
Now.
Well,
yeah.
You know one thing you did? You heated up the internet, too.
Mm-hmm.
You were the second most Googled celebrity at the Oscars behind Leonardo DiCaprio.
Ooh. Yes.
Wow.
Wait a minute. That blew my mind. Why? He won an Oscar.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, but he didn't wear that dress.
Okay, I'll take it. Thank you for Googling me so much, guys.
Was that fun? Did you have fun at the Oscars?
Yes, I really did. Yeah. It was great to meet you.
I know. It was so much fun backstage, right?
And you.
Yeah, I saw you on the red carpet and backstage.
Yeah, yeah.
We hung out. We had a good time.
Good,
it
was good.
Really Do you
fun.
Go to that green room?
I did.
Yeah.
I mean, I was...
Yeah.
Every break, I was... going back to the green room because everyone is having fun over there.
It's very funny.
While you're sitting at the Oscars, you just have to kind of keep that face because the camera was right in front of me. I was sitting with like Mark Ruffalo and like Naomi Watts and Kevin Hart. And I was like, okay, it's always on me. So my face was perennially pleasant. I didn't want to be
in trouble. You came backstage just to frown.
No, but people did.
Well, they had a bar back there.
That's not why I was backstage.
Oh, of course not. Of course
but
not.
But I'm a good Indian girl.
But, you know, last time you came to the show, we said, how did you get here? You said, I took the subway.
Yes.
So how did you get to the Oscars? Did you bike it?
I took a Rolls Royce.
Oh.
I thought I'd up the ante.
What an upgrade.
From the subway to a Rolls Royce.
Well, so tell me about that. So you're in your gown, you've got this beautiful jewelry on, you look fantastic, but then you've got to get into a Rolls Royce and you don't want to wrinkle, right? You don't want to step on your train. Do you lay down in the car or how does it work?
No, you know why I picked, I have my car at home in India is a Rolls Royce, and the best thing about the Rolls is the rug on the Rolls is like, it's fur. Like, you take your shoes off and it feels like a hug.
Yeah.
Really?
Yes.
It's like
it's like a hug.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I've not been in a Rolls Royce, but I'll take both of your words for it. Sounds amazing.
So I wanted to just be comfortable and getting out of a SUV.
Yeah.
In a gown is terrible, but in the Rolls you can sort of adjust the seat to how you want it to be. And my dress was actually super comfortable.
Do you want to know, I don't want to trump you, but do you know how I got to the Academy
Tell
Awards? A golf cart. Thank you. My job. My job.
But you know what we both have in common? We prefer being driven.
That's true.
That is true.
That is true, for sure.
And around here we have Flashback Friday.
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
And you were kind enough to submit a flashback photo. And here you are.
Oh, my God. Is that in India? Where is that? Where is that picture taken?
That is ninth grade prom.
A prom? It's beautiful. Why don't you like that?
Oh, my God. It's terrible.
Now, did you have a date?
Yes. I had a crush on this guy who, it was a junior prom and I was a freshman. I'm so bad. But I had a crush on this guy who was a junior. And this other guy who was actually my date had a crush on me. And I said, yeah, I'll go to the prom with you to meet my crush.
Always breaking a man's heart.
But now I know
better.
I know better.
You were 14 years old, for heaven's sakes. That's when you make those mistakes.
Well, you know, we got to take a quick break before I get my heart broken. And when we come back, we're going to find out from Priyanka what the latest scoop is on Quantico. So don't go anywhere. We'll be right back with Priyanka Chopra.
Tuesday on Live from the new series Flaked, Will Arnett.
Nathan Sykes and new girls Max Greenfield.
I thought you guys were going to applaud, but.
Priyanka Chopra in her hit show Quantico. And you play FBI agent Alex Parrish.
Yes.
And congratulations, you just got a second season.
Yeah.
That's a good sign.
Yes,
right?
Just today, so yes, I'm very excited.
And we know that the first Alex was framed for bombing, and they thought she was a terrorist. But now what's happening with your character?
Well, a second bomb went off at the end of the winter finale. And so finally people realized that what she was saying was right. There is another terrorist out there. And now she's exonerated. But in the second half of the first half, it's really confusing. Second half of the first season, she's exonerated, but the terrorist gets in touch with her. And now she and the terrorist, I mean, she has to figure out who within the FBI is the terrorist, because now she knows that it is someone who works with her. It's someone who watches her.
Do you, Priyanka, know who the bomber is?
No, I told the writers that I don't want to know, because I want to find out as soon as Alex finds out, because it keeps me fresh. And plus, I don't get into an awkward situation with everyone else.
Will they tell? Right, asking.
Right. Will they tell me if I called? I want to know.
They don't tell anyone. I think they don't know themselves, honestly.
They're writing it as they go.
And then you've been
on the fly.
And then I know you've been shooting a new Baywatch movie.
Yes, I am.
With The Rock and Zac Efron.
Yes, it's
How's
been
that
great.
Going?
I've just shot 3 days. I mean, after the Oscars, I went to Miami. I shot for 3 days. I came yesterday to New York for your show, and now, right now in the afternoon, I go back to Montreal to shoot Quantico. But Baywatch has been amazing. I play the villain in the movie.
Montreal and go to Miami,
yes,
right?
I know. You land there and it's amazing and there's a beach and it's hot and then you go back to Montreal. Yeah.
but you're the bad person and baby bad guy.
Bad guy in the movie.
Oh wow. Okay.
That's the beauty of it.
The beauty of it. The beauty of the beauty of being a bad guy. All right, the show is Quantico. It's on Sunday at 10 p.m. on ABC. Make sure you check it out. Priyanka Chopra, everybody. Are you okay over there?
Yeah, no, my skirt comes unzippered when I sit down.
All right, okay.
It's fine. Wardrobe malfunction.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know, it's time for our very first edition of Live Flashback Friday, where we crack open the vault and share some blasts from the past photos and videos. And we're going to start out, Kelly, with your flashback photo.
Yes. Let's see. Oh, that's me.
Cutie.
With my mom. And look at how tall Goofy is, but look at how tall my mom is with her hair.
Yeah, that's actually nice. That's a great picture. I love that picture.
Thanks. It's like the time we took a family trip. Anyway, let's see your flashback photo. You look the same. You never change. Are you wearing a sheriff's badge?
No, it was a baseball with like two bats.
I thought it was a sheriff's. I was like, is that your sheriff's shirt?
Yeah, back in there. I remember that picture too, North Carolina. And now we have a flashback photo mystery.
Ooh,
all right,
love a
see
mystery.
If we can figure this out.
Okay.
Who do you think that is?
Art Moore.
All right, widen it out.
Yes, that is Art Moore.
Yeah. What are you performing, magic?
Yeah.
Were you a magician?
Of course.
Well, yes.
You were?
Yeah.
You still know anything?
It's a secret.
It's a secret?
Do you ever talk to Neil Patrick Harris about that?
A little bit.
Yeah.
Not enough. We need to.
Gelman, I demand a segment of Art's Magic.
Art Magic? We did that one.
Magic with art.
You mean, in all the times you wanted to make me disappear, you've never been successful. Come on.
Wrap it up.
Okay, now, should we get to the audience?
We'll do it next time.
Next time. Okay, you can share your flashback photos with us through Instagram or Twitter using the hashtag LiveFBF or through our inbox at LiveKellyandMichael.com.
We'll be right back.
More information at LiveKellyandMichael.com.
Yeah.
And they're saying this is winter's last gasp.
Oh, I hope so.
They're saying that this is it. This snow is going to happen, and then it's going to be springtime galore around here. 68 on Wednesday. There are people in the audience from Florida like, oh my gosh, it's gonna be so cold. It's gonna be so cold here on Wednesday. You know, right. How do you like winter? Yeah.
Well, that's why
you're kidding. You know my in-laws, right?
That's why you love the snow, because you live in Florida.
They live in paradise.
You come up here and you dally in it and then you go home.
Yeah. Is that your only sweater? That's your only sweater, right? My mother-in-law has like three sweaters. She keeps them at my house because she doesn't really need them ever. But they're saying it's going to be the last gasp of winter. They're saying 70 degrees, Gelman. 70 degrees on Wednesday. Holy cow. Anyway, they always say this, though. They lull us into the falsest sense of security. And then it's May 1st. And then there's an unexpected snow squall that comes out of the north.
Because that's a crazy thing. They tell you this is the last gasp. Right. But they only give you a 7-day forecast. Right. So how do you know it's going to happen on the 8th day?
Because they're reading that Farmer's Almanac. Those farmers are telling us again.
I wish it were that easy.
So listen to this. It really is having a negative effect on certain things. You know, the Iditarod, that dog sled race.
So
in Alaska, it's so warm right now that they've had to ship... there's pictures up there. They're shipping train loads of snow for the opening ceremony because they don't have enough snow, which is really troubling because, you know, you think Alaska,
right.
You think snow.
Right.
That's like a guaranteed, right? Well, it's not guaranteed.
So for the Iditarod, they have to ship snow.
They have to ship the snow.
Those dogs are up there running going, man, it's hot out here this year.
You know, Mark did that when we did that.
Oh, yeah.
We did the show in Canada. and Mark did that dog sled race. And he said what's fascinating about it is that the dogs go to the bathroom while they're running. He was not, you know, expecting that. So you're piloting the dog sled and look out behind you. Because
you can't stop.
Yeah.
And if you try to stop, your buddies are pulling you.
But think about this. As a human being, if you didn't have to stop to go, think about how efficient we would all be. Right?
I'll be honest with you. Sometimes that's the only peaceful time you get. Not speaking from experience. I'm just saying. And do you remember Brandi Chastain?
Sure.
Of course.
Yes, you know, great friend of mine. I love this woman. She's so amazing. And she kicked the winning penalty kick in the 1999 Women's World Cup soccer match. Here she is right here. And then she did this. Show those muscles.
Yeah.
And, you know, that was like such a big moment for U.S. Women's soccer. Mm-hmm. Well, she now, and she's 47 years old, and she announced that she's going to pledge her brain to the Concussion Legacy Foundation yesterday. Huh. And what they're going to do, they're going to study her brain to see if she has CTE, which is from the movie Concussion with Will Smith, and what they found a lot of ex-athletes, not just football players, but athletes, have had from collisions. So I think that is an incredible and very noble and great thing that you're doing, Brandi. So I just wanted to shout you out on that, my friend.
Great lady. So the Obamas have decided, according to this New York Times article, that they're going to stay in Washington after they leave office.
Wow.
Because their youngest daughter is still in middle school and they think it's an important time. They want to let her finish out her school with her friends. And I think it's great. It's something
they're going to stay until she graduates. High school or just middle school?
I think middle school. She's in the middle of high school. She's a freshman right now, I think. Because I think she's Lola's age, right? Maybe? Mm. Yes? I don't know. They're saying that transferring someone in the middle of high school is very tough. And it is very tough. And so they're going to stay there until school's done. So good for them. I think it's a great thing to not have, like, upheaval
during those
years.
You know what's so cool? Like, you're riding around D.C. with your friends, and you're like, yeah, that's where we used to live. My bedroom right there, yeah.
I like the way you impersonate her riding around.
That's how I would be riding around if I were DC. Yeah, that's my old house. This is how I ride. And another thing, we talked about it the other day. We talked about, you know, surgery and people, you know, doing things to themselves.
Plastic surgery.
And plastic surgery. And I say, you know what? When you get tired of seeing yourself on TV or you think you look a certain way, you don't like the way you look, before you do anything to yourself, just It's time to just fade away. I mean, that was for me personally.
I agree, yeah. Which is why I gotta go.
No, you're not going anywhere.
Bye, sweetie.
You're not going
Bye.
Anywhere.
I'll miss
no,
you.
I refuse.
Bye.
I refuse to take your resignation.
All right, no, I gotta go. I gotta go, guys. Bye.
You
I'll
look.
Be back.
You look incredible. You look incredible.
No, you Stop. Said when you're.
Well, I said me. You look incredible. You look great.
You said so, when one is tired.
No. We're all tired. But you talk about aging gracefully in Hollywood. Yeah. Now, George Clooney said that he thinks pretty soon he is going to retire as an actor. No. I'm just reading it. I didn't say it. And he's going to retire because I think nobody really wants to see anybody really aging. And he's going to go behind the camera because he's a great director as well. And he said, you know, hey, your choice in roles changes and become less and less as you age.
And that's George Clooney
and
saying
that's George
it.
George Clooney. He said you just try to look your best and the best you can and not worry about it. But, I mean, if this guy is saying he's going to retire, holy smoke. If he's going to do it. Yeah, if he's gonna do it.
From Florida's West Coast, just voted the number one beach destination in the USA by TripAdvisor. Enjoy endless beach activities, dining in beach bars, an exciting kids program, spacious accommodations, and more. You pack your things, we'll pack your stay. Trade Winds Island Resorts. Your prize is valued at approximately $4,300.
Congratulations, Kathy.
Thank you so much.
We were just flashing back to John's belly button.
Yeah.
Now listen, you get to help make the day of a lucky member of our studio audience who will receive a $500 appliance package from Cuisinart. So please pick a number between 1 and 235.
30.
Yeah. There we are. Kathy, congratulations. Thank you, young lady. Congratulations to you too, everybody. Stay right there. When we come back, the very funny, the very talented, the very beautiful Tina Fey is here.
Still ahead online, we'll show you some of Kelly and Michael's flashback Friday photos. Don't forget to send us yours. From Quantico, Priyanka Chopra and...
Is that like, have you been in training for something?
Sure, yes.
Yeah.
For that,
yeah.
And now, we just saw you at the Oscars.
Yes.
Where you made everybody's list the next day of best dress, by
yes.
the way.
Thank you. I heard I made
you
your
art.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
And as you know, the live Oscar fashion panel is the most respected one of them all.
In all of journalism.
Yes, in all of journalism.
But thank you.
Do you like doing the red carpet, or is it weird?
It's
for
kind
you?
Of fun. I mean, that dress was Versace, right?
It's
that was
beautiful.
Like, you know, I was so grateful that they would make that for me. And yeah, you spend all day getting ready, and you're like, okay, I got this. And then you get there, and you like, I rolled up like in front of Charlize Theron, and I was like, oh, hey. I forgot. I'm an idiot.
do you like the process of picking out the dress? Do your kids help you?
They, you know, it's sometimes they'll be, they'll come over, they'll bring like, you know, a bunch of dresses over. And it's, I don't know if you have this, it's very stressful because I have a 4-year-old and it, and like, just like the 4-year-old just be like running to the dresses. And I'm just saying like, please have clean hands. Please don't have peanut butter on your hands. And my dog will be there like trying to like eat the bottom of like the hem of a jeweled dress. So it's stressful to do it at home.
We do it here at the studio and basically everything is like, Tina Fey didn't want any of these.
No.
And that's like what we try. But it's good. We're grateful. We have. We are like, we're, no, it's good. We like it.
But you talked about you saw Charlize Theron. I think you saw her on the red carpet when you were standing with me.
I was standing with you.
Because I'm standing with you and I hear you go, wow.
I cursed. And I turned around and I said, oh my God, we're not on the air, are you? Because I saw her and I was like, oh.
Yeah.
Right.
Well, and I cleaned it up by going, whoa.
And then I started I started spontaneously clapping. I started, I was like, I was like, who am I clapping for?
Was there any like celebrities that you're starstruck by or like a highlight celebrity?
I mean, that night is pretty bananas, right? Because you see
everybody.
I went to the Vanity Fair party. I saw Caitlyn Jenner came in and I was like trying so hard to be like, I was trying to make friends, like have an interaction with her, but she was She was through the room. She was a big deal. I saw Selena Gomez. You know, it's a crazy party when you're like, oh, I'll talk to Selena Gomez. Like,
right.
There's like somebody I know. Like, I don't know Selena Gomez.
There's a picture. My daughter loves Nick Jonas.
Yeah.
And he was talking to somebody, and there was a photographer there. So I leaned into the picture. And so I was like, look, I got my picture taken with Nick Jonas. She's like, he's talking to somebody else. You're just leaning in. Yeah. But it's like, makes you feel that
way. Like a big deal,
And now your girls are 10 and 4.
Yeah.
And have they started on social media? Because that's always been a contention with us here, with our kids.
Yeah, we're right on the cusp with the 10-year-old. She has an iPad now, and I set up the thing. She can, like, if she's home with the Wi-Fi, she can, like, text her cousins and, like, one or two friends. And I set it up so that everything she does also goes through my phone. Mm. So I'll be like, oh, somebody's trying to get hold of me, and I'll look, and it's just, like, 50 poop emojis that she's
next.
Glad I got up for that. And I also realized that, I was like, oh, this is not great. I realized that because it's all linked, my internet search history goes into her iPad's internet search history.
Oh, no.
I'm not up into anything shady, but, like, still, like, stuff that you might look at online, like, you don't want them to see. I saw a thing that was like, Hitler had weird genitalia. So I clicked on it, and I was like, oh, that's in her.
Right, I clicked on that. You know? We also clicked on that. We, like, went right to it. I was like,
now it looks like she looked at that.
I know.
We should talk about that.
You gotta erase your history. Constantly erase your history. Now, we have, it's Flashback Friday around here. We're doing this thing now. We're getting on the bandwagon of Flashback Friday 10 years after it happened.
Yeah.
So, we have a picture of you, right? A flashback picture?
I hear that you do, yeah.
Yeah, let's see.
Oh,
Is that your senior portrait?
That's my senior portrait. Yes.
Everybody wore the same black thing, right?
Yeah, they just threw it over your thing, and they gave us all the same fake rose to hold.
Yeah. It's like The Bachelor.
My haircut is pretty respectable for a 1988 high school graduate.
That's majorly good.
Like, because it could have been like this. It could have been
mine.
Right up.
It could have been like mine.
Yeah. Do you agree?
Mine is hideous. Mine's embarrassing.
It was totally opposite. Your hair was short and down, and yours was big.
I'll show you during commercial break.
Yeah.
It's embarrassing.
You went very New Jersey, Texas on us. We're going to take a quick break. We come back. We're going to talk to Tina about going to war. So we'll be right back with Tina Fey, everybody.
Still ahead on Live from Quantico.
Trot. Yeah. Gotta say it correctly.
Yes.
Yeah. Now, this is based on a book written by a real, a war journalist.
Yes, this woman, a woman named Kim Barker, wrote a book about being a journalist in Afghanistan. She went over there thinking she was going to stay for 3 months. She stayed for 3 years. She kind of got addicted to the lifestyle of chasing these dangerous stories by day, and then apparently the reporters...
And Michael Strahan.
It's Friday, February 4th, 2016. Welcome to the show, everybody. Yes. Interestingly enough, the audience now is behind me. Hi.
Hello.
I mean, like, way behind me. Like, I got to turn around to see them. That's new.
Yeah. We got a lot of people in here.
Yeah, are we adding people? Can't we, like,
rearrange?
Move them over that
just
way?
Just rearranging.
Having a hard time. I don't know.
Well, I feel sorry for these. I mean, I don't think they got to.
Yeah, these are the VIP seats.
How y'all doing behind the camera over
to
there?
To me, the VIP seats are always so funny because you really can't see anything.
So how are you doing?
I'm great. How are you?
I'm doing great. How was your night?
How was yours?
Mine was, nothing, actually. Yeah, I didn't really do much. I went to Lure Fish Bar and had a meeting, so I just went down to Lure And
when we lived down there, we used to live at Lore constantly. It was my kid's favorite restaurant.
Yeah, I love it.
Yeah, it's great.
And so I was just down there, had dinner, and I was home, and I was in bed early.
Good for you.
Remember yesterday when I said I go to bed by 9:30, and everybody was like, oh. Well, last night I was in bed by 9:30. Yeah. Feeling good today. I got some sleep.
Me too. Well, I didn't actually get some sleep. I watched the debate, the political debate, the Republican debate, with my children. So, yeah. Okay, so you know then what happened. So, won't do that again.
You know, I watched it, and then after a while, I just had to turn it off. I couldn't watch it anymore.
No, I watch it. I've been trying to, like, I want my kids to understand the political process. They're really at great. My older son obviously knows the political process, but the younger two are asking about delegates, superdelegates. How is this, you know, the difference between Democrats and Republicans and the platforms? And so we've been trying to watch everything, the town halls, which I love because nobody's shouting over anybody and everybody is, like, getting their message out. And then the debates. And last night's debate was, I have to say, and this is a nonpartisan comment, this is coming from a mother, was so undignified, I don't know where to begin. And I don't know if I can't watch this with my kids. I don't even know what to say about it. Like, if my kids spoke that way to each other, they would be grounded. They would really be grounded.
Yeah, I didn't want to hear any arguing after. At first it started out, and then everybody's fine, and then it's more of an attack. So when that starts happening, I'm like, why even waste my time?
No, it started
out.
There's
nothing that you haven't heard before. So that's what, like, the thing is. It's like, I'm not hearing you argue about something I never heard you argue about before. You know, it's kind of like me and my brothers back in the day. It's like, enough. Enough. Go sit down.
No, this was like a, I feel like this was a whole new level. And
so,
for those of you who know what I'm talking about, I just, like, I don't even know what to say. It has nothing to do with politics. I know that much. So I just am, you know, at a certain point, you have to say, we as taxpayers deserve people who are willing to talk about the issues and only the issues. And I'm tired of personal insults. Tired of it. It's like just trying to hear them talk about something other than the insult. I don't know. I got very upset. It really upset me last night.
Well,
I think because I was like, because I watched with my kids, and I was like, this is something we can do as a family. And then I was like, no, we're not. Joaquin, go to bed. Close your eyes. Cover your ears.
Yeah. Well, I'm over it.
Anyway, that was my message for the day. As I, again, it's coming not from a political place. It's coming from just a decency place.
Well, if I had this option, this is what I would have done last night, because I still haven't seen Star Wars.
I cannot believe that. Are you crazy?
You know what? I'm just the guy that when you say, you gotta see it, I'm like, it makes me want to wait. I don't know what it is.
Yeah, but to
just that rebellious part of me is kind of like, I'll get to it when I get to it.
Yeah, but
just because you say it.
To see it in 3D is really cool. Because
I have a 5D TV.
I'm sure
stuff
you
is shooting out the
I'm
side.
Sure you do. I
like
don't know what
you
that
got
means.
People
but
behind me, that's how my TV operates. Stuff is all around. But you but it would be great to see it in the theater, but, you know, I very rarely make it to a theater. But what they're saying, it's going to be available on April 5th on demand and on Blu-ray and DVD.
I'm gonna watch it again.
So I get a chance to watch it.
We've seen it 3 times.
You've seen it 3 times?
Movie
wow.
theater, yes.
But you know what?
We grew up, I mean, that was like...
No, when I grew up, it was big, but I just haven't made it to the theater to check it out. But they're going to have behind-the-scenes featurettes and 7 deleted scenes that they didn't put in the movie. And the movie has earned $2.05 billion to date. And then you know how much they're going to make off the DVD sale. I mean, it's going
right.
to be amazing. And I will be one to buy it.
Yeah.
So I haven't seen it yet, so I can catch them on Star Wars.
I keep thinking, like, the company's making so much money. Maybe we can get craft service here soon. No? Oh, okay. Nope. Nope. Still no craft service. Sorry, guys. Sorry, no coffee for you.
I think that's more
you.
Gilman than actually than the company.
I keep hoping, though. Anyway, you should see it. It's really, really.
I've only heard great things, and it kind of slipped my mind, and the next thing you know, it's already passed.
Well, especially if your kids aren't in town. Like, if your kids aren't in town, you're not going to... Like, I wouldn't just go see Star Wars, like, on a Saturday night. My kids say, come on, let's go see Star Wars again.
Uh-huh.
And I go, okay.
Oh, okay.
You know, okay, we'll do it.
Can somebody let me borrow their kids this weekend?
Yeah. Yeah. Who do you want? Which ones
somebody's
do you want?
Somebody's too willing to give their kids up. They're like, take them. Here, they're yours. No, I bring them back, okay?
Hey, they're saying that, you know, there's snow today on the ground. You see that?
Party very hard when they're not working. So it's just like...
Is that true?
Yeah, apparently.
That's what keeps them there.
That's what keeps them there.
Wow. Yeah, wow.
But this movie has a lot of action there. You're shooting guns.
Yep.
You're flying in helicopters.
Yes.
Now, were you ever scared? Because that sounds scary to me.
I got to fly in a Huey helicopter with Air Force pilots, and they kept saying, like, are you going to be able to do that? Are you going to be scared to do that? And I just kept saying, like, I don't know. I won't know until you walk me up to the helicopter. Right. And I go, like, no! But it was actually awesome. I loved it. Because once you get in, and it's these real, a female pilot named, I believe her name was Mary Clark, and she was, like, 28. She was so cute. She was 28. She had braces. She's like, sorry, I got braces. The Air Force is paying for my braces. She had already served two tours. But once you get in there and you're with these Air Force pilots, you're like, oh, they got this. Like, this
right.
is, like, would I take, like, an Uber copter to the Hamptons? No.
Right.
But this, I was like, yeah, give it the Air Force pilots are, like, unbelievable.
And they're all so young and smart and, like, brave. And brave.
So
the bravery of people is amazing.
Yeah. When you compare it to my own cowardice, it's so impressive.
But the gunfire, was it hard to learn to fire a gun, to shoot a gun?
Yeah, I took it real seriously. I fire an AK-47 in the movie, which is a serious weapon. And they go through this. It was a real one with blanks in it.
Okay.
They take you through all this weapons training, and they spent the whole morning, like, training me. And then when I finally went to go, like, shoot it, and they were, like, and rolling, and everybody, and then, like, way in the distance, I just saw, like, coming over the hill in the desert, just the, like, the snack lady carrying, like, a little tray of mini hot dogs. And I was like, no! Not now! Huge weapon.
Incredible. Never shoot that gun.
No, they're the most important
people on the set. Hey, listen, it opens today. The name of the movie is Whiskey Tango Foxtrot.
When we come back, Priyanka Chopra will be here with us.
A breath of spring. They tell us springtime is coming
I'm channeling spring because I go back to Montreal right now as soon as I finish your show to shoot Quantico. So I was like, you know, I'm going to be in like minus 200 degrees or something.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm from the tropics. I don't understand that.
Yeah. But don't you love Montreal, though? Isn't it like the greatest people, the loveliest?
Lovely people, lovely food, terrible weather.
Right. Well, you're there at the worst time, I think.
Yeah,
I've been there like six months now.
Well, you know one thing you did? You heated up the internet too.
Mm-hmm.
You were the second most Googled celebrity at the Oscars behind Leonardo DiCaprio.
Ooh. Yes.
Wow.
Wait a minute. That blew my mind. Why? He won an Oscar.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, but he didn't wear that dress.
Okay, I'll take it. Thank you for Googling me so much, guys.
Was that fun? Did you have fun at the Oscars?
Yes, I really did. Yeah. It was great to meet you.
I know, it was so much fun backstage, right?
And you.
Yeah, I saw you on the red carpet and backstage.
Yeah.
We hung out. We had a good time.
Good.
Did you go to that green room?
I did.
Yeah.
I mean, I was...
Yeah.
Every break, I was... going back to the green room because everyone is having fun over there.
It's very funny.
While you're sitting at the Oscars, you just have to kind of keep that face because the camera was right in front of me. I was sitting with like Mark Ruffalo and like Naomi Watts and Kevin Hart. And I was like, okay, it's always on me. So my face was perennially pleasant. I didn't want to be
in trouble. You came backstage just to frown.
No, but people did.
Well, they had a bar back there.
That's not why I was backstage.
Oh, of course not.
But I'm a good Indian girl.
But, you know, last time you came to the show, we said, how did you get here? You said, I took the subway.
Yes.
So how did you get to the Oscars? Did you bike it?
I took a Rolls Royce.
Oh.
I thought I'd up the ante.
What an upgrade.
From the subway to a Rolls Royce.
Well, so tell me about that. So you're in your gown, you've got this beautiful jewelry on, you look fantastic, but then you've got to get into a Rolls Royce and you don't want to wrinkle, right? You don't want to step on your train. Do you lay down in the car? Or how does it work?
No, you know why I picked, I have my car at home in India is a Rolls Royce, and the best thing about the Rolls is the rug on the Rolls is like, it's fur. like You take your shoes off and it feels like a hug.
Yeah.
Really?
Yes.
It's like cheerleading.
It's like a hug.
Yeah.
I've not been in a Rolls Royce, but I'll take both of your words. It sounds amazing.
So I wanted to just be comfortable and getting out of an SUV.
Yeah.
In a gown is terrible, but in the Rolls you can sort of adjust the seat to how you want it to be. And my dress was actually super comfortable.
Do you want to know? I don't want to trump you, but do you know how I got to the Academy
Tell
Awards? A golf cart. Thank you. My job. And my job.
But you know what we both have in common? We prefer being driven.
That's true.
That is true.
That is true, for sure.
And around here we have Flashback Friday.
Yeah.
Oh, gosh.
And you were kind enough to submit a flashback photo. And here you are.
Oh, my God. Yeah. Is that in India? Where is that? Where is that picture taken?
That is ninth grade prom.
A prom. It's beautiful. Why don't
really?
You like that?
Oh, my God. It's terrible.
Now, did you have a date?
Yes. I had a crush on this guy who, it was a junior prom and I was a freshman. I'm so bad. But I had a crush on this guy who was a junior. And this other guy who was actually my date had a crush on me. And I said, yeah, I'll go to the prom with you to meet my crush.
Always breaking a man's heart.
But now I know better, my
God. Now you know better.
Okay. I know better
now. You were 14 years old, for heaven's sakes. That's when you make those mistakes.
Well, you know, we got to take a quick break before I get my heart broken. And when we come back, we're going to find out from Priyanka what the latest scoop is on Quantico. So don't go anywhere. We'll be right back with Priyanka Chopra.
Tuesday on Live from the new series, Flaked, Will Arnett.
Nathan Sykes and new girls Max Greenfield.
I thought you guys were going to applaud, but.
Priyanka Chopra in her hit show Quantico. I'm leaving after this show today. I'm done.
Me too.
Oh, boy. And we all have things. Does Mark throw away a lot of stuff around the house, old stuff, or does he cut?
Mark is the most. Efficient person when it comes to clearing things out. He clears things out. I have to make sure I'm home because he will clear out things that have sentimental value. We had a storage unit once and he was cleaning out the storage unit and I caught in midair my wedding dress. It was going into the dumpster. Like nothing has sentimental value. It all just goes. If it's not making a streamlined appearance, it goes.
Wow. He needs to slow it down because there's this anonymous family.
Yeah.
Who were cleaning out the great grandfather's house in California earlier this week.
Mm-hmm.
They found this like crumpled up brown paper bag. They opened it up.
Mm-hmm.
There were seven authentic Ty Cobb baseball cards in it.
Wow.
That were printed between 1909 and 1911. There were only believed to be about 15 of these cards in existence before they found this bag.
Unbelievable.
And now these seven cards command or worth over $1 million.
Wow.
That's incredible.
Yeah. So I will be in my base, my attic, if anybody needs me.
Probably was like.
This afternoon. That's right. Crazy.
All right, well, should we move on?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. Already?
Hey, Tina Fey.
All right, I wanted to show one Downton Abbey clip. But
okay, sure.
Yeah, it's, you know, Downton Abbey is it's bidding us adieu. It's going, I know, it's sad. And we were all saying that we're really sad around here, not so much that we'll miss the show, but we will miss dressing up like the people from the show for Halloween. So we just want to show you, we want to leave you with one last Live's Halloween Downton Abbey clip. So take a look.
We've lost everything. We're ruined.
Ruined?
Ruined.
Ruined.
Ruined?
Let's do something to save Downton.
What to do?
What to do?
What am I gonna do?
So
I'm going to miss using my accent.
Yeah. I just want Art to dress up like that all the time. Why can't we have Art in a wig and lipstick and false eyelashes every day? Please?
He's not having it. There he is. You're not having it, Art.
Please? Where is Art? Where did he go?
He's hiding.
He's hiding in a corner over there. But we have a big show today, everybody! And also, Priyanka Chopra is here.
And today is Live's first edition of Live's Flashback Friday, where we will be sharing some of our own flashback photos. So will Tina and Priyanka, and we want you to send us yours.
Yes. So either write into our inbox with your photos, or you can go and send it to us on Twitter or Instagram and use the hashtag LiveFBF. And we will we'll look forward to seeing them later on in the show, and we get a chance to show some of them, okay? Oh, I hate when I drop my snowballs. All right, everybody. Our dancer is in position, ready to go. And let's kick it off with our Snow Wild Travel preview.
Is Veronica Lisbon from Ambler, Pennsylvania.
Hey, that was some hot stuff over there.
Hi, Veronica.
Now, Veronica, great job, by the way. Thank you. And let's say hello to Kathy Perkle from Vancouver, Washington. Hello, Kathy. How are you?
Hi there, Kelly and Michael.
Hello. Now, Kathy, what do you do for a living out there in Vancouver, Washington?
I'm a labor and delivery nurse.
What? Oh, my gosh. You are. Let me tell you something about you, Kathy. You are the most important person in the world.
You're nice.
Are you working right now?
No, I'm not. I don't work today.
You know what? You have a very subtle, like, soothing voice,
yeah,
too. If I were having a baby, I'd want you there.
Hey, Kathy, I heard from my OBGYN that when babies come out that aren't so cute, you guys say, "Oh my gosh, what a baby!"
I guess that has happened.
Well, you know, you sound like you're a very stressful business, so we're going to hopefully be able to send you on a vacation somewhere, spin the wheel.
Oh, here's a great prize, the Tradewind Island Resorts in St. Pete Beach, Florida. You can go visit my in-laws or the lady in the last row. It's 7 days and 6 nights. It includes one spa treatment per person. This trip is provided in part by Hotels.com. It's a prize valued at $4,300. You have 20 seconds and only one guess, Kathy. Good luck.
Thank you.
All right, here you go, Kathy. On yesterday's show, we talked with John Stamos. In addition to his legs, what other part of his body did John say he was self-conscious about? What other part
his belly button?
You got it!
Congratulations, you and a guest will enjoy 7 days and 6 nights at the Tradewinds Island Resorts, located on St. Pete Beach.